everybody, ChristopherOdd here, welcome back. This is XCOM 2 Operation Twisted Paramore. We need to rescue Dr. Jack Hoggins, a scientist worth 97 intel. And we're taking on two squaddies and two rookies to do this. Baron, Calantro, Easterbrook, and Angmar. We've renamed Easterbrook's weapon to Training Day so that we can pass this among the rookies because it's got the scope on it. We've also installed a mod for the Sky Ranger. So it looks pretty amazing, actually. Pretty happy with it. Look at that. It's awesome.
Sky Ranger deploy.
Squad green to deploy.
We just got word from the spokesman. Apparently the aliens have captured a VIP of critical importance to the resistance effort, and they'd like us to handle the rescue operation. We'll need to lock down the area, free the VIP, and evac the target as quickly as possible.
I also installed another mod that I'll show you once we get in. I think it's really cool. It's very smart. It shows us, like, which icons are going to end our turn, which we can use for free, which will not end our turn, that kind of thing. And updates them dynamically, so. We're heading into the Advent Security Zone in Guadalajara. This is Operation Twisted Paramore, eventually. And things should be good. I'm liking the look of this little... like, I don't know, platform here where these stairs lead up to? Hope we actually see that. There she is.
Menace 1-5, we have a confirmed location for the VIP. Move to rendezvous.
How close is that to extraction? Eh, not bad.
Our position is masked.
Not bad. So, look at this. The way that this is done is it shows you which moves you can use that will end your turn. Those will be in blue. The ones that will not end your turn right away are in blue. Just like, you know, your first move. Blue equals, you know, you can still do things. Yellow means it will end your turn, and white is like a quote-unquote free action. So, now, this is interesting. We have this cell right next to an entry point. We go in through the window. We'd have to unlock... well, two doors, this one, we just run through them. But if we do that, we don't have a lot of great high ground advantage, but we are near the edge of the map, so I think that's gonna be our best option. We can use the roof that he's on, or that he's under, I should say. But for now, let's just worry about making it that far.
That's affirmative. I've got enemy movement here.
Oh, beautiful, look at that. Okay. Nice thing about having a map with a lot of different high ground is that the enemy's going to want to use it too.
The aliens are putting in their heads for entertainment.
And then we could just, like, then we could use a grenade and just put them down.
Go, go, go.
And they'll die pretty quickly.
Closing on target position now.
But I imagine if these guys are going to patrol, they're probably not going to be up there for very long.
Moving to Overwatch. Moving to Overwatch.
Now they might even just leave right now. Or not. Okay, so we actually, we have a really good option here to just, to engage. But then we only have 10 turns to make it all the way here and all the way out. That's very risky in my eyes. Very risky in my eyes.
Heading there now.
I think what I'm gonna do is... pull along the side here. We'll just keep eyes on them. We'll watch them carefully, see what they do.
Moving on target.
But I don't think this is the right time to move in.
Affirmative.
If they go down, that's fine, because that gives us access to the rooftop. Yep, keep going. That's fine by me. I'd much rather engage when we're closer to the VIP. So, this is good. Now, we're going to find another group, it sounds like.
Eyes on the enemy.
Yep. Four troopers. One's up top, three are below. Right by our other entry point. But that's controllable. So, I'm okay with it. I'm going to bring Calantro. I'm going to bring you way in here.
Time to motor.
Diamonds, you can grab the garbage can. Banshee, let's move up.
Heading to that location.
And Chupacabra. Let's bring you down here.
I'm all over it.
So So that's two pods that we know of. And where's their other trooper buddy? Or is that maybe a different group, I wonder? Or he might just have to take the long way, because he was actually on the second. Yeah, he took the long way. Poor guy. He plays it off. He plays it off cool. He's like, meh. Totally knew what I was doing there. So now, this is actually great. Now we're going to get up here and try and get high ground vision with all of our guys. We could move her here. It's not... Like, we'd be safe there, unless, of course, they decided to climb up here. Maybe for now, let's just get everybody up top. Actually, like, this true concealment's pretty fun, because I feel like, it's more tactical. I don't think it is, but it just feels like, okay, I'm gonna set up, and then we're gonna go in, and we've got that, we don't have that extra pressure, but once we engage, it's like all hell is gonna break loose, so it's kind of fun. Let's bring Calantra way over.
Moving out.
And Chewie. I just worry that they come up here. That's why I'm kind of putting our guys behind this thing right now. Because I don't want to get flanked.
Let's do this.
We have the skylight to worry about, so that's something to consider. Somebody pointed out that our Overwatch all kind of conflicts with custom classes, so we're using two custom... Oh, shit. Really? Oh, that is the freaking worst, man. He might just shoot back, too. Because we're concealed. Nope. Come on, somebody. We only had one Overwatch. Okay, well, the other group didn't come at us yet. We're relatively close to the VIP. Things could be worse. Things could be better. Don't get me wrong. We could use grenades to knock these guys down. Unfortunately, oh, that could actually hit them both because of a bounce. So that's cool. I don't think we can make that happen over on these two. I mean, we've got Chewie, who could use his grenade. He could probably get these two. Oh, I think it was there. Yeah, so we could knock those two down, and those are guaranteed kills if they fall. But we might not even need to do that. Like, we have flank shots on all of these guys if we want them. I think we gotta believe.
Moving to
position. Oh, shit. Did we just trigger another group? Fuck! That sucks. Okay, well. I know what we want to do now. Can we get the bounce from here? I don't think so. Oh, maybe. Oh my god. Just like that, we're in hell. Maybe I can't get the bounce there. I mean, I can put her out here, then, like, easily flank from this side if we don't get the kill on that guy. I'm not a fan of any of this. This is all BS. Like, that was not cool. Okay, one option we have is we can knock these two down. Or we can knock these two down. I think knocking these two down gives us a little bit of breathing room. We're still flanked, but we're gonna try and knock these other guys down with grenades, maybe, or just kill them outright. Maybe I should move them first and then do this. Yeah, let's move them here. We could move them into the full cover, but it might be too close, and I don't wanna, if we do that and we blow out this floor, then these guys from the bottom might see us, right? So I think we'll move back here, try to get these kills another way. Come on.
Here, catch.
Sleep tight. Nice. And he got the kills without the fall damage, right? Because I think if you get the kill with fall damage, yeah. If you get the kill with fall damage, it doesn't even, like, give you credit. Now, he's got some guys to deal with below. The sectoid is what's worrying me the least currently. But if I could knock these guys both down, I would. I just don't think I can get it. There's no bounce, there's no lucky bounce or anything that I can really take advantage of. Come on, Angmar. Let's go, Angmar. Yes. Nice job.
X-ray neutralized.
Okay. Then I can bring diamonds over. We could try the same thing.
I hope it's worth it.
Come on, 95, baby. Nice.
There you go.
There you go. And then... I mean, this is pretty good. It leaves her a bit exposed, but if the other soldier does come around to get a shot on her, as long as it doesn't crit, she can live. That's assuming that this hits. Yeah! Okay, now we gotta wait to see what the sectoid does.
Oh, you see that?
And this guy, because he could still kill her. And that would be bad. He's out of here. He's gonna bring the zombie up top. Smart. Oh, he brought the zombie from below. Yeah, see, he is gonna come up here and flank us. That's... or... not. Okay. We have a way out of this. Miraculously. Grenade over here kills him. And gets us immediate access to our VIP. Unless, of course, this hits the VIP. But it'll warn us if that would be the case, so... I think, like, that's actually not bad. And then we can get in here for 3 flank shots from high ground on the sectoid. It's doable. And see how this is white? Because it's the free reload because of the autoloader? That's cool. I like this. I think this is just... you know, it takes... you don't have to think... I like that. Is this gonna kill our guy?
Catch.
Nope. Good. Surprise! We're here to rescue you. I know it wasn't like the most graceful entrance of all time.
What's over there? Heading out.
And yeah, this is still flanked.
Is it clear?
These are all hundreds. Now, who do we want to get this kill? Let's check if these are all. Yeah, they're all hundreds. Except for Angmar, So you know what? Let's take this first. Nice job. I think trying to build up kills on Chupacabra here is not a bad idea. Because we need promotions to get the Guerrilla Tactics School upgrades, so. Okay. That's a little bit of a shitstorm, but okay, for the so time being, one. Anyways. Now, how badly do we want those weapon mods? Great question. Cool thing is we can pop right in here and not trigger anything that might be nearby. And then we could just pop right back out, couldn't we? Sure we could, and we can move along this way, which is probably safer. Move along these walls, which I don't think have any windows, and then get close enough and just beeline it to the exit. That's the thought process. Let's see if it actually pans out that way. Yeah, we'd have to run around here to get out, but
here I come.
Let's bring Calantro in. Hello.
The VIP is secure and we're on the move.
Look at him.
1-5 status confirmed. VIP is in tow. Proceed to the extraction point.
That's Hoggins wearing a safety helmet for winter sports. But you know what? He probably knew we were coming, and he's like, knowing these guys, they're just gonna blow the ceiling out. And I'm okay with that. I'm just going to be prepared. So, pretty cool. And I actually just found out about this way to rotate the map if you hold Alt. I don't know if that's from the mod or if that's built in, but I just learned that. And I think it's really cool. How badly do we need these weapons? This weapon mod. I just so badly don't want to find another group out there. You know? I just don't know if my heart could handle it.
All right, I'll
Fuck.
Go.
It's gonna do it. Oh, maybe not. That pause could be from just picking up the weapons. Which I think it is. Okay, Illyrium core and an advanced stock early on like this. I am not gonna complain
it's
about
over
that.
Over here.
Okay, and then I'm just gonna bring her way
it's
over.
Clear.
Choopy. Bring you down here for now.
It's worth it.
Banshee, same thing.
On the move.
We could hack the door. I think we might be better off doing that next turn. We could actually, depending on if there's enemies in here, we could just move to this door and be fine. So that's actually not a bad option. Let's just overwatch here in case we have enemies roaming. On this side. Let's get him as close to the door as we can. And, let's just overwatch it. Oh, fuck. See? Well, that's actually not terrible, but...
Menace 1-5, we're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position.
That's actually not bad. Okay, let's open this up.
Attempting a breach.
All right. Superior hacking skills are about to kick in here. Look at that. Amazing. Delays current dark event by 2 weeks or soldiers hacking stat permanently by 20. on our sniper. I mean, they're both terrible. So let's go ahead and grab the one we have the best chance of getting. Oh, shit! No. Not even. Please don't be anything inside.
Got it.
Nice. Okay. So... couple options, actually. Maybe we just bring these guys in. Because there's no windows here, right? No, there's no windows. Maybe we just bring everybody, you just run them in here, and then we can just run to the extraction zone once these guys drop in and get the hell out of here.
Finally!
Hell yeah. Let's do it.
Got it. Moving.
Forget these guys. I'll just, we'll take that and be happy with it.
Got it.
Lose a little bit of experience from the kills that we're not getting here, but forget it. If we can get everybody out alive, get the objective done, I'm all over it. Unless, of course, they drop in an Overwatch, which I think the only thing it does that is those Mark II mechs. Unless that's changed. It's possible. I don't know.
They're repositioning our position.
Oh, shit. How do they drop in there? Oh, look at that. I mean, okay. So, wait. We have some options here. We could, I mean, we could... If we run out, let's do this. Let's run out here with Hoggins, and if we see like any other enemies, then we know that we should just get out. But if it's this group, maybe we can fight them.
Okay. VIP secure and in position.
Hoggins
for
is secure.
This is Firebrand. VIP is secure.
Now, if we wanted to, we could get out of here. Even though it shows Chewie is not being able to make it, it's because these two are in his way somewhat. So, thing is she only has a pistol shot if we want to move her. And I just don't know if we're playing this a bit greedy, because they will start to overwatch to stop us from getting there. But I feel like these are a couple of easier kills that we could just grab. I don't know what the right call is here. The captain was back here, I think, somewhere. He could be right there. Just thinking we might be pressing our luck a bit, you know? Or we could use her to get the kill on this thing with a pistol. Unless she hits for 2 damage, which is totally possible. But if we move these guys in, there's 2 flanks. The other option is to just use his frag here. We could do that. These guys already have promotions. It'd be just nice to get some on our more established groups here, but we're just, I think it's a big risk. It's a huge risk. This would be a flank as well. I'm really undecided on what I want to do here. Like, I gotta believe that we could kill these guys. Let's go for it.
I'm on it.
Come on, Angmar. There's one.
Target eliminated.
We're gonna bring Choopy over here to flank this one.
I'm going.
There we go. Good job.
Happy now.
Okay, then what we could do is bring Easterbrook in here, use the grenade on that one.
I'm going.
The Advent officer still can't see us.
Get ready for a surprise.
And if he does come in here, these guys are all in good cover. And then we should be able to move her back and have vision of this guy, no? Not quite. Well, there's a chest here I didn't even see. My only worry about moving her up here is that the officer probably sees her. Almost guaranteed, right? Wait. No shots from up there. We do have a shot over here, but if he comes in here, then she's flanked. Would he sacrifice himself like that? It's possible. I could go in there. He's probably gonna move. We could just try for an Overwatch kill. Because the thing is if we move up there and that officer stands there, well, he'd be flanked too, so he may want to reposition. He could still take a shot. The chance of him killing us is low. If he marks and then shoots us, it's better for him. I'm going.
Let's do this!
Oh, and he actually doesn't see us.
Okay. You can't handle me.
Let's see. It's repositioning. Oh, right. I forgot
multiple
about that shit.
On our position.
Oh, well, thankfully it's way back there and we're getting the fuck out. Okay. More Balatin is right. Oh, shit. Chewie! Chewie can't make it. Chewie cannot make it out. Unless I have an idea. I do have an idea, right? Those guys are far enough away where it's not really going to matter, I don't think. Let's bring Easterbrook and flank him.
What's over there?
Okay. Can I bring... I can flank with Banshee as well. But Banshee does not have... actually, Banshee can't shoot. So, what I'm thinking about doing is blowing out this wall so that Chupacabra can move up. Maybe even just move up one space and have a shot on him. Kind of a fucked up way of getting there. It's kind of not ideal, is it? Because if this screws up, I need to make sure that maybe we should just... Maybe we should just be getting these guys out. Yeah, I think we're overstaying our welcome here.
All right, I'll go.
So we're gonna get these guys out.
Evac confirmed.
And if I could go in here and toss a grenade, I would, but we can't do both, unfortunately. So I'm just gonna leave.
Roger that.
I'm gonna leave with these two.
I'm out of here.
Yeah. We're leaving him behind.
Packing it in.
Temporarily. Temporarily.
Move.
He could very well overwatch. And he probably will. Oh my god, those reinforcements, that's terrifying. I forgot about that. No!
Got the map in here.
What? There are sectoids in there the whole time? No way.
Enemies on the move! They're flanking us!
Is he gonna overwatch? No, he's moving. Thank fuck. We are out of here. Holy shit.
Go, go, go!
Go, go, go is right! Holy hell!
Ready to boogie!
I cannot believe that.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
I cannot believe that. And 9 enemies left still. So we had those 4, 5 with the officer, and the 4 that he called in for reinforcements. Holy shit. what were they doing in there the whole time? Didn't they hear all the commotion and be like, hey, maybe we should go help? Nope. Don't care. We made it. All right. Hey, the movement thing is working again. Now, somebody said that it only shows as, like, not working if it was an exact tie, which I guess could happen a lot. But then some people were saying, no, it's always bugged, so it doesn't show the person who moved the most. But regardless, team rating, common soldiers. I like that. What else we got here? Shots. We hit 100% of the shots, but all of them were, like, really good positions, so I'm okay with that. That was pretty intense. That was fun as hell. I actually really like true concealment, and I still feel, and maybe it'll kick us in the ass later, but I still feel like it's a really good balance with the extra enemies. Nice, look at this. Chupacabra got promoted. This is fantastic. So we now have a corporal. We go blast padding or we go shredder. Early on, I like blast padding just because it makes him a bit more survivable and we don't run into enemies with armor for a little while still. So, yeah. We could always retrain. Let's grab blast padding. Now let's see what our new rookies are. Another ranger. Okay, very good. Very good. We'll take that. Made swords usable, so that's fun. And another trooper. All right. It's kind of open for grenadiers, but we'll take it. Advanced stock. Here's our VIP. Still wearing the safety helmet, Mr. Jack Hoggins. It's good. We'll add you to the research team.
You have dealt another serious blow to the aliens' efforts today, Commander. Impressive work.
Okay. Research time decreased by 33%. I'll take it. 4 days on debris, 15 days in the guerrilla tactics school. Would have been amazing for that to be an engineer and just pop him in there and get that going a bit faster. But in 4 days, we'll split the difference here anyway. So it's not too bad. Actually, yeah, no, we'll probably do that.
Suspicions, but before
no,
now,
we won't, because we'll have to build
here. Resources to investigate the possibility of clandestine advent facilities built up out.
Okay, so there's some supplies up there. I think we can get both. We can get the other scientists and then move towards the supplies.
Avenger plotting new course.
Hopefully. Alien biotech, here we go. The chip. I wish there was more insights into Tigan's past. We get some things like here and there. But yeah, it's not as much as I would hope.
Clearly been modified to allow for their subordinates to receive new orders psionically.
So the Advanced Warfare Center is open to build now. It wants us to do communications or the officer autopsy, both of which are good. We could go sectoids for psionics, which you don't really need. I'm honestly tempted to just rush mag weapons, but we are going to need resistance comms before anything else.
I'll see that work begins immediately, Commander. I'll contact you when I have a full report available.
Dr. Sky Nelson is our new scientist. No portrait here, but I bet we can go and find him somewhere else. Let's see.
Hello, Commander. Work is well underway, but it will be.
Oh, we can't even see him.
Before my research
That's too
is
bad.
Complete. From my own.
I mean, we could do process of elimination.
Advent generally deploys heavy security rather than subterfuge when it comes to protecting their primary facilities, at least the ones I had access to personally. If they have gone to the trouble of hiding this black site, I suspect our findings there will lead us to even greater questions.
Look how cool that looks, the Sky Ranger. I have a mod request that I would love to see is for the random guys that are all around the base, I would love to see like a little overlay saying who it is. Sometimes you don't know and they take off their helmets and stuff, but I don't know where everybody is right now. Because there's like only a couple in there. Nobody's in my quarters, thank God. We've got one here. Oh, here's the bar, maybe. No, it's empty. Where is everybody? They're probably outside. It's a nice day. Look at that. That's so cool. Look at the giant cliffs. Oh, it's, I love this fucking game so much. Sorry. Just dropping F-bombs here unnecessarily.
Avenger plotting new course.
Now, do we get timers on when these... oh yeah, expires in 11 days. And I wonder if they can expire mid-scan. Okay, debris is cleared, thank you. That's good. We definitely want to get the AWC going. And it's pricey, but it's necessary.
Commander, we've pushed our current power systems to the limit. We don't have any capacity to spare, which means we can't expand our facilities further.
I understand. So we can assign them there. Let's see, it's gonna take 42 days. If we assign them, should knock it down to 21. It will. And I think this is a pretty big priority to try and get this cranked out as fast as we possibly can. The only thing is, we could get the guerrilla tactics in 5, which frees up an additional engineer, does it not? Or no, we only have the one, don't we?
New orders, Commander?
What am I thinking? Yeah, we only have one.
Pickings are slim, but I'm hoping we find a few more recruits who can handle a wrench. I could use the help.
And guerrilla tactics, I think our first upgrade isn't until our next promotion anyways. I think it's at Sergeant. Because this would be squad size 5, 6, 7. Oh, maybe it's not. Maybe it's lieutenant. I can't remember. Is it in here? Not quite. I always have difficulty remembering that. Regardless, it's okay.
Just give the word and I'll get started, Commander.
So, do we want to try and get this going faster? Or maybe we should just have them start clearing out alien debris. Because that's going to take time too, right? Or do we get this one going and then do alien debris? Maybe let's do that. Because after this, we're going to need to clear out a space, build power for sure. And then we're going to have to start moving down. These ones are going to take even longer to build out. So, let's get the guerrilla tactics done in 6 days, and then we'll decide what to do. Resistance comms, there we go.
Results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
Thank you. And then, look at these, 32 days. That's not actually that bad. It's really not. The autopsy we'll hold off on for a bit. 32 days, that's like before, that's before the Advanced Warfare Center would be ready. At this rate.
I had assumed you'd make
the radio
a priority, Commander. I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
Commander. We can now work to establish contact with local resistance groups operating out of regions around the globe. Once we've collected sufficient intel to make contact, we'll need to scan the target.
Nothing on the local comms.
Oh, shit.
Advent's been quiet lately. I'm guessing we have you to thank
we'll
for
watch
that.
It. We'll watch
our pleasure,
it.
Den Mother. Enjoy it while it lasts.
We plan to. Our water purification...
Massive signal coming from the Advent Network Tower. It's global. Sir, I think you want to see this.
Fellow citizens, for 20 years, the Advent Coalition has worked tirelessly to repair the ravages and injustices of the old world. Under our stewardship, our cities prosper, our people flourish, and our world heals.
And yet,
among us, there are still those who would refuse to acknowledge the truth, who are determined to see all that we have achieved.
Multiple radar contacts on approach to Haven Alpha 7.
That must end.
Even as I speak to you today,
you've got incoming on approach.
Your signal's breaking up.
Outlying territories to end this scourge once and for all.
They're right on top of you.
Losing you, Avenger.
Raise them again.
We will ensure your continued safety and well-being throughout this crisis.
Get your people out of there!
With your cooperation, we will overcome these radical elements and usher in another 20 years of peace and prosperity.
They don't stand a chance. Commander, we should get a squad ready to deploy.
Oh my god! Oh, this is so crazy. All right. Retaliation. Ah, this is gonna be freaking tough. This is gonna be really tough. Now, we've got, this seems to be, it says defend Resistance Haven. So is this the new one? I think so. We'll need to respond quickly to prevent further civilian casualties. I think this is the new Terra mission. Now, they're not always gonna be the same. But I think that's what this is. I could be wrong. I think it is because they've implemented this really awesome idea that I had. It's not, I shouldn't say it's my idea, but it is something that I talked about and thought of on my own a long time ago. But I was saying something about how on Terra missions, we should get like a rookie, like one of them should join us. I think that would be so cool. And this new mod with this new type of retaliation mission gives you that, which is super cool. So Franklin Eckholt is available if we can get there. Now, we do have to take out some of our better guys, I think. Is the Rogue the right call, though, I wonder? I actually don't know if it is. The other thing is that after this, a lot of these other guys will come back. So maybe we do take the best of the best. I just don't know if the Rogue is the right one. It's our SMG, and let's review what we have. We've got Phantom and Blindside. So we have to go for flanks. He's got the extra mobility, which is nice. But his regular shots have a aim penalty of 5, so. Let's see, let's just change up your weapon color a bit here. We could do like a dark orange. Then, oh, I actually like that. That looks really cool. So let's stick with that. We'll take a look at the weapon upgrades after. We've got a ranger out here. Now these guys, because of the sword changes that we made, this could actually be super helpful on these missions. The swords have been modified slightly, and I've got the instructions below. Let's go with a deep red. And we could probably match his armor type if we want. It's the, not plaid. Digital. We could do that. Maybe we don't need to. We can grab one of these. Stars and stripes, that's cool. XCOM Medic, Vietnamese Starburst. Let's do that. I love it. Let's see what weapon upgrades we have. We have the stock. Right, so actually, I think this might be good on an SMG. Might be good on an SMG because it's going to hit for less anyways. So if we do his loadout here, the SMG does 2-4 damage. This guarantees that at least we're doing 2 every time we're shooting. I can get behind that mentality. We could take out a trooper. And at this point, the trooper is nice because it gets the first shot with the pistol. I really know nothing else about them. But that's 2 shots every turn. So pretty happy about that. And what else do we want to do here? We could take out our specialist, Mr. Parker, or we could take out a sharpshooter. Might not be a bad idea. Let's do that. Our specialist isn't really going to add a lot, I don't think. And here, what we'll do with Biscamp is we'll actually give him... We'll give him training day. There we go. Even though he's not really training, but we might as well get the benefits. And that's something I'm going to try to focus on a little bit more, is like using our weapon modifications a bit better. I'm going to go ahead and put the advanced stock on here. Yep. Take it. And I think this is a good squad. This is a pretty good squad. We just need to give you a better looking weapon. What goes good with blue and yellow? More blue and yellow. Green's good, purple's good. Oh, like a dark brown could be cool. And I think... Oh, look at that. U.S. Night Desert. That's cool. That's really, really cool. I could spend hours doing this stuff. And I have. And I have. Anyway, okay. This is our group that we're taking out. A whole bunch of balaclavas, I think that's what those are called. And, yeah. Here we go. It's going to be Pike, the fisherman, Keller, Biscamp, and Edwards. Apparently, Keller might be related to Polo. Just saying. Wish me luck, guys. We'll see you next time. Bye.
The world you once knew is no more. Earth is now ruled by the Advent Coalition and their alien masters.